who do you listen to today? This is a world full of opinions. It's opinions galore. Everybody seems to have an opinion about cars, about houses, about political parties, about what to eat. And we need to be careful who we listen to, especially in spiritual things. In 1 Thessalonians 5 and verses 3 to 5, it says, "For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But you, brethren, are not in darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. You are all the children of light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness." Now, what is Paul saying here? Well, he's saying that the world today will say that there is peace and safety, that all is well, there are no problems, don't have to worry. They, I suppose, would refer to the world who know not God, and they would have an opinion that this world is fine, it will go on, and Jesus won't come again. There will be no destruction, there will be no judgment, there will be no accountability. Later, later, just look around you, things are well. That's their opinion. But the problem is that this is not what God says. And God is saying all that they are opining over is that from darkness. It's like a blind man trying to describe an elephant. The world will say there's peace and safety. But God says, you are not in darkness. Don't listen to those opinions. You are the children of day. And I'm reminded today that I must be careful, that I should not listen to human reasoning. It may be logical, but as a Christian, I should not live by rationalization, but by revelation. And the children of light have the revelation, the light of God's word in the Bible. Psalm 119, beautiful text. "Thy word is a lamp to my feet, a light to my path." Friends, walk in the light today. Be careful of buying into the opinions of the world, which are in darkness. But be careful to base your life on the clear light of God's revelation in the Bible. God bless.